So good morning friends, this is Tarun Nanwani and I welcome you to my channel Sweet Nectar. So today's topic is Ganesh Chaturthi. So I will tell you a little bit about Lord Ganesh and this festival Ganesh Chaturthi. Now Ganesh Chaturthi falls in the month of August or September of the Gregorian calendar. It is also known as Vinayak Chaturthi. The festival is marked with the installation of Ganesh clay idols privately in homes or publicly on elaborate pandals. Ganesh is the younger son of Lord Shiva and Goddess Parvati. Ganesh is known by 108 different names. Observations of this festival include chanting of Vedic hymns and Hindu texts such as prayers and ratha. Offerings and prasad from daily prayer that is distributed from the pandal to the community include sweets which are called as laddu, as it is believed to be favorite of Lord Ganesh. The festival ends on the 10th day after start when the idol is carried and in a public procession with music and group chanting. Then it is immersed in a nearby sea or river. In Mumbai alone, around 2 lakh statues are immersed annually. Thereafter, the clay idol dissolves and Ganesh is believed to return to Mount Kailash to Parvati and Shiva. Ganesh is believed to be god of new beginnings and the remover of obstacles, as well as the god of wisdom and intelligence, and it is observed, I mean, by all the people throughout India and also abroad. A sacred mantra of Lord Ganesh is Vakratunda Mahakaya Surya Koti Samaprabha Nirvidna Kuru Medeva Sarvakaryeshu Sarvada. It means salutations to Sri Ganesh, who has a carved trunk, who has a large body and whose splendor is similar to million suns. O Deva, O Ganpati, please make my undertakings free of obstacles by extending your blessings in all my works, always, always. Now I'll tell you a small story that how Lord Ganesh was born. Now Parvati created Ganesh out of dirt of her body while she was having a bath and put him to guard her door while she took her bath. Shiva entered and knocked the door to enter to his home. But as Ganesh did not know of him, he stopped Shiva from entering. Shiva got enraged and ripped the head of Ganesh. After a fierce fight between the two, Parvati was enraged when she came to know about this. Shiva promised he will bring Ganesh back to his life. Shiva ordered Devas to find the head of a person facing north, but Devas could only manage the head of an elephant. Shiva fixed the elephant's head on the little child and brought him back to life. And thus Lord Ganapati was born. And that's it from me for today, friends. Get back to you again. I hope you like this video.